Next, we're going to look at trigonometric functions in MATLAB. It's super, super important to remember that MATLAB always assumes that you're in radians and not degrees. So if I type in sine of 90, hopefully, oh my gosh, hopefully you know that the sine of 90 is not in fact zero, but the sine of 90 is one. So if you get this, you're like, wait a second, that's not right. Now you know the sine of zero is zero. So you check it out and you're like, okay, well that's right. Well, of course, because it's also zero in radians. So the sine of 360 should also be zero, but it's not. That's because MATLAB thinks in radians, as it should, because it's a big boy. It uses the metric system too. I actually don't know if it does. But anyway, MATLAB is always pretty much assuming that you mean radians. So if I'm going to type, if I actually want to know the sine of 90 degrees, I have to know that 90 degrees is actually equal to pi over 2. So quick review. We have to remember that if I have something that is in degrees, that I have to multiply by pi over 180 degrees. That way the degrees cancel out. And I end up with pi over 2. If I have something, so this is degrees. Let me try to spell this correctly. Degrees to radians. This is something that every, you know, person who knows math should be expected to know. Multiply by, not by pi over 2, by pi over 180. If I start out in radians, and if I want to go to degrees, I multiply by 180 over pi, 180 degrees over pi. The pi's will cancel out, but not always. In this case, they do, but I'm left with degrees. So if I'm going radians to degrees, I have better handwriting whenever I'm not trying to type over my computer. Degrees, then you multiply by, what did I say? 180 over pi. That said, it's pretty much expected that you should know, you know, this equivalence of 0, 30, 45, 60, 90, 180, 270, 360. So pretty much without thinking, you know, you should know that's 0, you should know that's pi over 6, pi over 4, pi over 3, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and 2. Okay, so you should just know these. Seriously, you should just know these. You should also know the sine and cosine and all of those, and the tangent, because if you know sine and cosine, you should know the tangent. Anyway, so as you're practicing with your trig functions, remember that pretty much always MATLAB is assuming you're meaning radians and not degrees. All right, so again, these should be relatively familiar. I'm going to pull these over. Pachonk, pachonk. All right, so sine is exactly what you would expect it to be. Sine of pi over 2, 1. Now it's important that I'm actually typing pi over 2. It might be like 3.14159 over 2. I'm going to get an answer that's kind of okay, but if I format long, if I do sine, oh, come here, and I run this again, see, it's not actually 1, it's all these 9s and zeros, and that's because I haven't really given it pi, I've given it some thing that kind of looks like pi, but really isn't pi, because the only way to get pi is to do that, okay? So just note here that this isn't quite the same. Okay, this is an approximation and doesn't give me the right answer. All right. Go back. Cosine, same thing. So cosine, I know that the cosine of 0 should be 1. It is cosine of pi should be negative 1. And it is, so that's good. I know the tangent of, 45 degrees is square root of 2 over 2. No, sorry, that's not the tangent. The tangent of pi over 4 is 1. That's why I typed it, the cosine and the sine of pi over 4 square root of 2 over 2. But anyway, the tangent of 45 degrees is 1, so that comes out right. You could probably guess, looking at this, that a sine is actually your arc sine. This is your inverse sine, or arc sine, or on your, you might think about it like sine to the negative 1. Just so you know, so if I say arc sine of 1, I would hope to get pi over 2, maybe. And I can't really tell if that's pi over 2 because it's in radians. let's call it times, since it's in radians, I don't want to convert it back to degrees times 180 over pi. There, 90 degrees. So now notice if I say arc, so arc sine works, arc sine does not work. So this does not, no arc sine. Also, it does not work to say sine to the negative 1 of 1. That also doesn't work, so more no. Don't, any combination of that, anything you try to do with that, that's not going to work. It's just straight up arc sine. This is your hyperbolic sine. We call that sinh. Sinh. Arc hyperbolic sine, or inverse hyperbolic sine. I don't know what you call that. Hypersinh? Arc sinh? I don't know, it's been a while. Now these down here are kind of fun. Sinh, and you're like, I've never heard of that, let me try it. Sinh of pi over 2. What is sinh of pi over 2? Well, that makes no sense, so what do? Everyone, we don't know what a function does, we write help, sinh. And it's like, sinh is a sine expressed in degrees, and you're like, that's amazing! So I could actually come in here now and I can say sinh degrees of 90, and it'll come back with a 1. And the arc sine of 1 would be 90. Or, yeah, arc sine of 1 would be 90. So this is actually the D. Now, I think that those work for sine, for cosine. So I can say cosine D, and I can do tan D, and that makes sense. I can go arc tan D of 1, that should give me 45 degrees. I don't think I can do sin D hyperbolic of, I don't know, 90. Yeah. And if I want to know if there's something similar to that, I can say help sinh, and I'll say, yeah, hyperbolic sine. Overloaded methods, that's not really, yeah, I don't think that there's going to be anything else like that. So, but they do work for kind of the basic sine, cosine, tangent, and stuff like that. So that's pretty good. All right. Now, interestingly enough, so if I ask for sine of 180 degrees, I expect to get, so what do you expect to get for sine of 180? What's the sine of 180? You're like, I don't know, 0? Yeah, sine of 180 is 0? Wait, D. Sine of 180 is 0, that's good. Let's find the sine of pi. And those should be the same thing, but they're not. So sine D of 180 is 0. Sine pi, which should still be the sine D of 180 degrees, is just a super, 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 super small number. And that just has to do with computational limitations. Oh, I don't know how much I want to get into this. That said, in real life, like if you had something where a lot of times when you're programming, you have like kind of a fudge factor for when things are equal to 0. So like if this sine or if this pi was like some value you could put together, this is totally off topic, has nothing to do with what we're doing, but say that, you know, x was pi, and I didn't necessarily know what x was going to be, but I did want to know that if the sine of x was equal to 0, I wanted to display the value hi. All right, and don't worry about what I'm doing, but if I run this, see, it's not telling me hi. I'll even CLC clear it. So I'm running it, nothing happens. So a lot of times, instead of saying, is this going to be exactly equal to 0, what I would say is it less than some super, 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 super small number? And a lot of times I'll say, is the absolute value of it less than some super small number, but that's okay. So what I was kind of like grumbling about is sometimes I'll even say if the absolute value of it is less than some super small, because if it's like negative. But anyway, so a lot of times instead of thing, are those things going to be equal to 0, we use this is called an epsilon. And again, totally outside the context of what we're doing, all I just thought it was kind of cool is to show you that MATLAB messes this up, just because it's fun to make fun of super expensive software that only sometimes works. No, it works almost all the time, it's just fun to break it.